Listen up. There is nothing more ridiculous than being born into this world to be alone. The sea is vast. Someday you will meet friends who will protect you. Run with all your might. Go and live with them. Hello and welcome to One Piece 101, the series that breaks down everyone and everything in the One Piece world. Today we will be examining the ever-friendly giant, Jaguar D. Saul. Jaguar D. Saul is a giant who primarily features in Nico Robin's flashback, encountering her on the island of Ohara. He has an incredibly cheerful and friendly personality and is often characterized by his particularly unique laugh in the series, which is dereshishishishishi. In general, Saul's personality tends to differ greatly from most other giants we've met in the world who have a strong focus and desire for battle, and a lot of that can be explained by the fact that Saul wasn't born on Elbaf. It is currently unknown where exactly he was born, but his existence implies that there is at least one other colony of giants out there in the world. As a result of this upbringing, Saul has demonstrated a strong distaste for the traditions of Elbaf and sees their citizens as somewhat barbaric. Other than that, unfortunately little is known about the history of Saul, except that at one stage he enlisted in the Marines and eventually rose to the rank of Vice Admiral. As part of his duties, one day he encountered a vessel of wanted criminals who turned out to be scholars from the island of Ohara, who had set out to research the mysterious poneglyphs scattered throughout the globe in an effort to decipher the events of the Void Century. Despite Saul's wishes, the Marines directly under his command ended up killing all but one of the individuals on the ship, and the sole survivor was a woman by the name of Nico Olivia, the mother of Nico Robin. Sometime later, Saul was summoned to a meeting with Sengoku, where he was informed that he had been selected as one of the five vice admirals to lead a buster call on Ohara. However, due to his encounter with Olivia, Saul had begun to doubt the course of action decided upon by the world government and sympathized with the scholars as people who simply wanted to understand the history of the world. Furthermore, he even reprimanded the Marines for their senseless slaughter and demanded proof from Sengoku that these scholars were as evil as the world government were claiming, to which Sengoku promptly told Saul to shut up and follow orders. Now, oddly enough, that blind imperative did not put Saul's mind at ease, and the giant went to visit the captured Olivia in jail, willing to listen to her story. And you're not going to believe this, but after hearing her side of things, Saul broke Olivia out of prison and abandoned his position as a vice admiral of the Marines. In doing so, he made it known to Olivia that there was no way he could stay with such an organization whilst harboring such a large amount of doubt within himself. Saul then volunteered to deal with their Marine pursuers, while Olivia made her way back to Ohara. However, eventually Saul's vessel was shipwrecked by a storm, and rather fatefully, or conveniently, whichever you prefer, he washed up on the island of Ohara, although he didn't know this fact immediately. There he encountered and befriended a very young Nico Robin, who visited Saul frequently as he built his escape raft. It wasn't until it was far too late that Saul learned Robin was the daughter of Olivia, and that he had washed up on the worst possible island. By this time, Olivia had arrived on Ohara, as well as Cypherpole 9, a secret cell of agents under the direct control of the world government. As Saul rushed to locate and get Robin off the island, the leader of CP9, Spandeen, triggered a buster call on Ohara, an event in which 10 Marine battleships led by 5 vice admirals are summoned to quite literally destroy an island. Saul found Robin in the embrace of Olivia, who was naturally quite shocked to see Saul on the island. Olivia then requested that Saul save Robin from the impending destruction of Ohara, as she had things she still needed to do on the island. And it would be during this effort that Saul displayed the incredible strength that had no doubt been a great asset in his rise to becoming a vice admiral. During the course of his attempted escape, Saul was hit directly in the face by a cannonball, and not only did he immediately get up after the impact, but he proceeded to lift an entire battleship out of the water and throw it directly into a second battleship, effectively sinking both of them. Saul was then confronted by Vice Admiral Kuzan, who would go on to become Marine Admiral Aokiji, and despite Saul's phenomenal strength, he was no match for the Logia powers of Kuzan. Knowing this was the end, Saul gave Robin some powerful final words, encouraging her to search the vast sea for her Nakama that will surely protect her. And he reminded her that when times got tough, she needed to smile and laugh just like him. Saul was then frozen to death with a smile on his face. Some more fun facts about Saul. Saul is one of the exceptionally rare characters in the series who possesses the middle initial D. As with all characters bearing this initial into the story, Saul has been subject to the machinations of fate, and his death even echoes that of Pirate King Gold D. Roger and Portgas D. Ace, both of whom also passed away while smiling. With that said, Saul himself seems to be very unaware of the meaning behind the Will of D, although he did state that everyone in his family had inherited the middle initial. Saul made an appearance in Chapter 0 after it became known that Gold D, Roger, and Shiki were about to engage in a battle that would become known as the Ed War. Although he didn't really do anything, he was just seen walking with Garp and a posse of other well-known characters in the series. In theory, Saul is a Haki user, as it has been stated that all Vice Admirals and above need to possess Haki in some form. However, neither of the three brands were ever displayed by Saul. And finally, a truly useless fact. Whilst as a member of the Marines, Saul wore a standard Marine cap. However, when he defected, he decided to adopt a cool cowboy-esque head covering. How very renegade. But that pretty much does it for Jaguar D-Saul. If you enjoyed this video, then please feel free to like, favorite, or subscribe. And if you are in any way inclined to support this independent channel, then also please feel free to check out my Patreon, Discord server, or Twitter, the links to which are in the ever handy description below. And finally, please do comment with who, what, or where you'd like to see featured in the next One Piece 101.